I'm on a 4-week backpacking trip in southern Africa. I'll be travelling through 4 different countries, covering a distance of around 3,000 kilometres. This time, I'm in Namibia. The Namib Desert, at 80 million years old, is the most ancient desert on Earth, and is home to some of the highest sand dunes on the planet.
This is definitely your experience.
Before heading into this desert wilderness, the group and I say goodbye to South Africa in style. First day of G Adventures, and we've come to a place called Cederberg, which is in beautiful wine country. We've been doing some wine tasting, so all the group's a little bit tipsy already, but everyone seems amazing. But this place is absolutely incredible. It's quite possible that tonight's going to get a little bit messy.
Here's the wine. We just buy it again from them and reset it.
On personal escort.
Okay. If we go 865, that's 19, and then we can go 2 to tiny bars.
I think it's safe to say that everybody is a little bit drunk right now.
You had a good Come on!
Into the chopper!
Hello, Ben. Alright, so it's day 2 of our African adventure. We've just arrived in a beautiful campsite. We did quite a lot of driving today. I think we drove for 6 hours in total, which was alright really, because the scenery was brilliant and everyone was a bit hungover from last night's wine tasting. So if you look behind me, you can see Orange River, and straight across the river, the other side, that is actually Namibia, and we swam across there today. So I think tonight we're just all going to chill around the campfire and have a few beers and get to know each other a little better. The Orange River is the longest river in South Africa. It stretches 2,200 kilometres and runs through 3 different countries. The river forms part of the international border between South Africa and Namibia, and it plays an important role in the South African economy by providing water for irrigation and hydroelectric power. I don't know whether you can see how sunburnt I am, but it's actually so hot here. and our CAO told us that it's actually going to get hotter. This is pretty cool. Wow. But it's all good.
You're a good soldier, choosing your battle. Pick yourself up and dust yourself off and back in the saddle. You're on the front line, everyone's watching. You know it's serious, we're getting closer, this isn't over. The pressure's on, you feel it. But you got it all, believe it. When you fold it up, oh, oh. And if you fold it up, eh, Tamina, sangalewa. Cause this is Africa. Tamina, mina, eh, eh. Waka, waka, eh, eh. Tamina, mina, sangalewa. This time for Africa.
Well, we're officially in the middle of nowhere. Absolutely beautiful. But it's so hot.
Deadvlei is a clay pan located near the more famous Sappheiros. It was formed by a river that flooded, creating pools where trees were able to grow.
Woo!
Then the climate changed. And over time, sand dunes surrounded the area and blocked off the river. The trees died around 700 years ago, leaving a miniature paradise frozen in time.
I've never seen anything like this in my life. Oh my god. If you ever come here, make sure you bring plenty of water. I'm literally out of breath.
Guys, the place is still getting bigger and bigger. Of course, in the beginning, it was much, much smaller, probably closer to the ocean, and then the dune started taking over, all right? So today, the desert itself, or the dune itself, actually almost reached the limit, all right? It can't really get any bigger. All right, so the dunes stretches about that distance, roughly, and then a little bit north, you get the Swakop Moon Dunes.
Namibia is the second most sparsely populated country in the world. It has only around 2.4 million inhabitants for a country around three times the size of the UK, which has 65 million. To our next camp, we stopped to climb Dune 45, which is a star dune that stands a whopping 80 metres high and gives 360 degree views of the Namib Desert. The dunes here were created by sand that was carried by the wind from the coast and the rest of the desert. They create a star-like shape and consist of sand that is over 5 million years old.
that is a dinosaur plant, alright? It's not the name of it, but it's called a Balbutia. Right, so the first discovery was here in the 1850s.
At our next camp, a few of us joined a guided desert walk where we learned how the Namibian wildlife was able to survive in such harsh conditions. Since water is so scarce, most desert animals get their water from the food that they eat. Smaller animals like lizards and spiders live underground where it's a lot cooler. These animals stay in their burrows during the hot days and only emerge at night to feed.
Somehow it's good for big animals like oryx, springbok, kudu, mountain zebras, tenbok, ostriches. They're really happy because they get more food to eat. But for little things surviving the sand, it's not good for them, just killing them. One big shower is welcome, please, not more. Hot is not a problem, dry is not a problem. If it's raining a lot, just killing them. Then we are 80 kilometers from the sea, 80. Sometimes in the morning, the fog pushing inland, you find beetle, they call the head standing beetle. Have six legs, long legs, is standing right on top of the dunes like this. The head is down. This part must catch feed of the fog, following the line down to the mountain and drinks. Zebras, when the sun going down, all of them on the way to come and drink it. Like said, one group comes, they drink. Then also, oryx and the zebras, they're moving like a group, sometimes five or six, that is the family, or eight. If it's a big animal, family, like 16 together.
I'm the number one Aussie on this trip.
Starting to feel a little bit more like the Africa that I imagined.